I mentioned earlier the 37, over 37 programming languages that .NET supports, and most of those languages are what we would consider static or compiled or type-safe languages. And we recognize that, especially with the web, there's a lot of energy and a lot of excitement around dynamic languages because of the rapid prototyping that they allow, and sometimes the more intuitive syntax. So with Silverlight, we actually have support for Python. Our implementation is called Iron Python. We have a managed JavaScript implementation as well, and coming soon, a dynamic version of Visual Basic, today called Dynamic DB. Over time, in a future release, the Ruby is a very popular language, a lot of energy in Ruby today. You will be able to program Silverlight using Ruby as the programming language of course. So again, as a developer, you choose the language, and we provide a platform that will work great for you. You don't have to learn one language for developing on the web server, or another language for building RIA, and yet a third language for building desktop applications. You can choose one language and carry it with you. So similar to before, everything that you've seen in the second part of the demo with Top Banana, with the Expression Studio and Silverlight demonstration that our tour did for us, Silverlight 1.1 Alpha, which includes the .NET support, is available for download today. You can go ahead and download that and start building your chess game if you want. The Silverlight tools for Visual Studio, which I showed very briefly, Visual Studio Orchestra just reached Beta 1, and the tools add-in for that to do Silverlight development is available for download as well at Silverlight.net. And the dynamic languages support, we've taken an additional step of releasing the dynamic language runtime as well as our Iron Python implementation to CodePlex, which is a shared source community where you as a developer